Good afternoon. It's my honor, first of all, to be here and to have some kind of discussion with you regarding Korea's ODE, focusing on social and economic development of Korean experience last 6 decades. Before I start, I'd like to give my special thanks to Dr. Oh Jung-hoon, Professor Oh Jung-hoon, who invited me cordially to this very, very important lectures today. And I'm very happy to be with you because 30 years ago I'm here in this university as a master's degree in public administration. And at that time I was very younger and then always eager to know the social science at the time. And then I'm very fortunate to have a very good professor at the time to teach me the methodology of social science. With this kind of foundation, I went to state to study my further study in political science. And back to Korea in 1991, I joined COICA. When COICA was founded, maybe you know COICA or not, maybe not. COICA is a Korea International Cooperation Agency implementing grants and technical cooperation for developing countries. It was almost 24 years since the foundation of the COICA, and then I joined COICA at the time, and then right now I'm Vice President of COICA, and I'm very happy to be with you to talk about ODE and Korean development experience about you. Almost 30 or 40 minutes we'll talk about my lectures, and then question and answers session will be followed by that. If you have any questions in your mind, please feel free to raise your hand, and I'm ready to respond to your questions about that. So, first of all, okay, let's start. There are many parts to talk about you with a very short of time, so the speed of my saying is a little fast than you expected. Please, understand my things. Seven session which I'd like to talk about you. Briefly, I will explain to you our Korea's ODE. ODE means Official Development Assistance. In other words, foreign aid. But generally speaking, instead of a foreign aid, we use ODA, Official Development Assistance. Korea's brief system and policy, followed by COICA, my agency at the grants. Very short introduction will be followed by that. And I would like to, this is my highlight of my lectures, development experience from three perspectives: capacity development and economic development and the social development. The three perspectives I would like to analyze our experience from that point of view. And how to link with COICA's activity with this kind of three development perspective of that. Finally, I will touch how to enhance aid effectiveness, which is main topics of international global villages, especially UN, focused on aid effectiveness rather than aid quantity or whatever. These are seven topics you'd like to focus on that. So I will ODE system first. ODA, maybe I talk to you, Official Development Assistance, right? Official Development Assistance, in other words, ODA or ODA. Pronounce ODA or ODA or Official Development Assistance like this way. Korea's ODA system, as you see in a diagram, divided into bilateral and multilateral. Bilateral I mean, this is a direct assistance from A countries to B countries, from Korea to Vietnam, from Korea to Rwanda, from Korea to other developing countries. This is, we can say, bilateral. Meanwhile, multilateral aid means not directly to developing countries, but through international organization, World Bank, UNDP, or WFP, we can say multilateral aid. Bilateral aid subdivided into grants and loans. Grants is consist of grant aid and technical cooperation, which my agency COICA is implementing right now. And we are under the umbrella of Ministry of Foreign Affairs. And loans is also, you can see EDCF loans, Economic Development Cooperation Fund. Right now it was implemented by Export-Import Bank, Action Bank of Korea. The policy is generally designed by Ministry of Strategy and Finance. On the other hand, multilateral aid also subdivided into contribution to international contribution. This is directly dealt by Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade. And another type of multilateral aid is a subscription. Subscription. This is to international financial facility, for example, World Bank, IMF, Asian Development Bank, Africa Development Bank, IDB, whatever. This is, we can call it subscription, is implemented by Ministry of Australian Finance. This is very simple. If you look at the other advanced countries' organization structures, this is very similar to Korea. But the main feature of other advanced donor countries is that almost 95% of ODA is grants, bilateral, and 70% of bilateral and 30% multilateral. And among grants and loans, 95% are grants, and loans are just 5%. So general trend is grants and technical cooperation is the main tools of ODA. So, but in case of Korea, bilateral and multilateral is very similar to other advanced countries, 70 bilateral and 30% multilateral. On the other hand, grants and loans is concerned is different. Grants is right now is 53%. And the loans are 47%, something like that. So our government decide to increase grants up to 60% by next year. So we hope that more and more grants will be given to our ODA programs. And why? Grant is preferable to loans. You will maybe a question to me, but I will respond to you later. It is very interesting that the Korean National Assembly passed a law, so-called ODA law, in 2010, stipulating five main goals of ODA in Korea. First, poverty reduction. That is a general ODA programs. Every country has a poverty reduction is their main goal. And Korea is the same. Second, enhance human rights of women and children and realize gender equality, gender empowerment, something like that. Third, sustainable development and humanitarianism is welcomed. There are many issues, controversial issues surrounding ODA. Some countries focused on very economic interest motivations behind the scene. But on the other hand, in case of Scandinavian countries, they are focused on very humanitarian perspective. But some countries focused on quite political driven motivations behind them. Each country has different motivations. But in case of Korea, generally speaking, sustainable development, humanitarianism is welcome. enforce economic cooperation with the partner countries, promote. That is economic motivations also at the same time. And finally, peace and prosperity of international communities are stipulated in our ODA programs. These are five main goal or direction or vision objectives of Korea's ODA programs. What is principle to visualize this kind of objective? Three. The first is combine needs of partner countries and then the accumulated experience of Korea. That is very true. We have very good experience in escaping vicious circle of the poverty in last 5 decades. Therefore, we'd like to share that kind of experience with developing countries like this way. Second, maximize and the effectiveness by integrated approaches. Integrated, I mean, there are so many 8 types. Technical cooperation, grants and loans, whatever. It's a speech of volunteers. There are so many programs who are public-private partnerships. So in order to make more effectiveness, we have to integrate more chemistry among many types of it, which can induce aid effectiveness. Third principle is deliver aid sincerely with the two hands. Maybe some of you are foreign students, but you do not know what is the meaning of two hands in Korea. To provide something with two hands means to respect. This is our old tradition and culture. So we do not want to impose Korean experience to other developing countries. We would like to share. So I prefer share rather than transfer. Share our experience with other countries, respecting their culture, respecting their tradition, respecting their human rights. These are very important part of it. They live sincerely with two hands. These are three main principles of Korea's ODA. Look at the change of statistics. In 2000, our ODA volume was $210 million. But last year, 2 years ago, last year was not yet. It was formulated in the end of this year. But 2 years ago, almost 1.6 billion. That is the first time for Korea to increase more than 1 billion. So 8 times increase last 10 years or something like that. This shows strong commitment of Korean government toward developing countries to tackle the poverty in the world. Asia 65%, Africa 16%, Latin America 7%, and others, international organization, whatever, is others like this way. Asia is our main partners. Generally speaking, EU, Europe has focused on Africa. United States focused on Latin America, something like that, or Asia Pacific or whatever. And Australia focused on Pacific countries, Fiji, Samoa, PNG or something like that, because they are their background, backyard of it. So it is necessary or natural for Korea to focus on Asia first. But it does not mean that we ignore the poverty in Africa and other countries. Our government decided to triple our ODA to Africa by 2015, next year. So when you look at the COICA statistics toward Africa, 2008, just 8%. But last year, it was almost 20%. This shows ODA in Korea generally. In COICA specifically, we focused 20 plus percent to Africa. We have right now 44 overseas offices in the world, Croica. Among them, Africa is 14 overseas offices, number one, more than Asia. What it means? We focused on Africa for that. My agency's program, Vision, Making a Better World Together, focused on together, not alone. It's very important, not alone. COICA, with a partnership with our local NGOs, local mass media, local academia, universities. On the other, we also have focused on partnership with the international organization UN, World Bank, as well as advanced countries, USAID in US, DFID in United Kingdoms, AFD in France, GIZ in Germany, JICA in Japan, OSAID in Australia. There are so many aid agencies there. We'd like to combine their comparative advantage with Korea's together to tackle poverty is the main goal of that. So our vision three is same to our Korea's ODA law, alleviation of the poverty, achieve MDGs. What is MDGs? Millennium Development Goals of partner countries, and assist sustainable social economic development. I like the words sustainability. That is the word which I always emphasize to our staff. The aid effectiveness is really rely on sustainability, not just a one-time delivery. So sustainability is the most important word which I describe to everyone to persuade why sustainability is important. Without sustainability, I think it is not effective. And promote humanitarian assistance and human security or something like that. Mainstream selection of focus. What it means? Our ODA volume is quite small compared with other advanced countries. Therefore, we have no choice but to focus on some area, some sector, which we believe have a good result. Look at Rwanda, very small country in east part of the Africa. But we focused over many types of Rwanda. Why? Rwanda is very good countries. They are good governance is there. The president of Rwanda, Mr. Kagame, has a pretty good vision. And no corruption at all. Maybe you are very strange to hear that there's no corruption in Africa, but that is true. If you go to Rwanda, maybe you are thinking, reminds of genocide of Rwanda in 1984, but that kind of memory was gone. Mr. Kagame was also minority, Tutsi race of that ethnic groups, but he overcome every kind of thing. Right now he become the president of Kagame, of Rwanda, have very good vision of it. And we, Korea, would like to have some kind of support to implement his vision. And then to have some kind of hope to Africa, especially in Rwanda, spread to other countries, Rwanda, Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Mozambique, Ethiopia, whatever. So we have no choice on the selection and the focus is our main strategies and share our experience, as I told you, and respect their needs and ownership of partnership. Respect local ownership. As I told you many times, how important local ownership. When we drive the car, who is driver, who is staff? In the past, the advanced technocrats, advanced donor was in the seat of a driver. Developing countries just, you know, sit beside the drivers, which leads to totally failed aid. Therefore, right now, the the you know position was changed. Donor countries in supporting groups, and developed countries in driver seat. That is so-called local ownership, respecting the, it's their hand, their will to have something, not the donor's will. So it is very important promoting participation of Korean civil society, as I told you, our NGOs, local NGOs, academias. There are many stakeholders right now involved in this process. It's very welcomed. I'm very happy to have more and more groups would like to join activities together. Quaker program sector, education, health, energy, industry, rural development, IT, governance is change it. Asia, Africa, Latin America, Middle East, East Europe, and CIS. East Europe and CIS is no more at all because they already graduate the recipient of ODA programs. Therefore, it's almost East Europe and CIS was always gone, especially excluding Uzbekistan. Uzbekistan is still our main partners. Let me turn to Korean experience. Some of you know, the Korean students know the Korean history about it, but I don't know what the other foreign students think about it. Last 6 decades, very simplified, 3 stages in our economic and social development. The first stage, until 1960, our main, Korea was a least developed countries, very poor countries over there. After Korean War, everything was destroyed. Infrastructure was destroyed. Millions of people was killed. Still, South and North Korea was divided into that. Our GDP was, per capita was 67 US dollars. This is a very low compared with as of today. And received a huge amount of ODA from all of the countries, especially from the United States and the EU and the UN, which is, I think, a basis for our economic social demand, almost 12.7 billion US dollars. Converting into current prices, I think 60 billion US dollars. So you imagine how much we rely on ODA in 1960, 70 or something like that. But in 1960, later, we have a very strong president, and he has strong leaderships. And maybe you hear 5-year economic development plan, 5 times economic development plan, which played an important role in Korean history. And also at the same time, 1980s, we have overcome democratic struggle in 1980, and then to have political development as well. As of today, Korea become the donor countries and also OECD DAC members about that. GDP was sold almost like this way, and then our GDP per capita corresponding to more than 23,000 US dollars, something like that, compared with 67 in 1953 to 23,000 US dollars in as of today, which shows how fast Korean economic development was over there. As of today, Korea become donor countries of that. Let's turn to different experience from 3 perspectives, capacity development, economic development, and social development. Korean theorem started with capacity development. World Bank analyzed the secret of Korean economic and social development from three perspectives. The first, strong leadership. Second, very effective public administration. Third, very efficient human capacity. These are three main factors to describe the secret of Korean economic development. One of the things is Korean development is capacity development, capacity building. We have abundant human resources. However, 1960s, our government has high enrollment rate in primary education, secondary and the third tertiary educations, focused on capacity building. And your father and mother generation, I am also, is one of the beneficiaries of Korean government's education policies. Two, and then our father and mother generation sacrificed their welfare to focus on the money and everything for their offspring, education. So I am one of them, and I'm very happy to be with that. And we have very skilled labor forces were reared by our vocational training center, secondary and tertiary economic growth like this way. State-led development, five-year development plan, which I mentioned just before, and also foreign aid aligned with our national priorities. That is the reason why we would like to focus on our developing partners' priority area. We do not want to drive our ODA from political and economic perspective. I don't want. Maybe some of them are too focused on that, but I don't want. First of all, very humanitarian, international standard focus. And then followed by economic and social development will be followed by that. So I do not want our ODA to be driven by that. And also, our assistance should be aligned with their priority. When the United States, USAID, provided enormous amount of ODA to Korea in 1960-70, they tried to teach Korea to do something to this way. But we said, no, that is not our priority. Please, listen to our voices like this way. Fortunately, USAID listened to our voices very carefully and then aligned to our priority area too. So we are very fortunate to have cooperation with USAID at that time. Sometimes aid agencies forced the developed countries to do something based on the priority of not developing countries, but donors' perspective. This is not good at all. This is our experience. Therefore, I would like to share with this kind of thing with other partners and endeavor to prevent corruption. It is not easy, especially corruption is concerned. This is sometimes linked with their domestic policies, whatever. So we are very sensitive, skillful to do something, this kind of thing toward other countries like this way. Capacity development with institution building, which are able to develop their own ability to cope with different tasks. For example, when COICA was founded in 1991, we invited many public officials, technicians, students from all over the world to Korea. Maybe right now, the GISS in Korea University also have a COICA student here. You may encounter COICA's program student or not. These are one of them. COICA right now has provided many, many seminars, curriculums, which covers agriculture, computer, IT, or economic development. There are so many courses open every year. Almost we invited 8,000 public officials and technicians from all over the world to Korea to share our experience. Last 20 years, almost 80,000 public officials was invited to Korea to share our experience. One of them become prime minister. Almost more than 100 invited here to back to their countries become minister or vice minister. There are so many, you know, high-level bureaucrats came to Korea to share, to understand what Korea is all about, and then back to their countries to would like to implement the good experience with their countries as well. Cambodia training programs. There are, for example, Cambodia, we have many 2,000, I don't know, 2,000 or 2,500 public officials invited from Cambodia. If you have a chance to visit Cambodia officials, almost half of their public officials have a chance to visit Korea to share our experience. In the past, we have many programs, water, sanitation, IT, multipurpose dam construction, rural development, international relations. So this covers national, social development, economic development, rural development. There are so many courses which Cambodian officials have implemented and back to their countries. And also, Laos Republic's stock exchange. From 2007-2010, we opened Laos Stock Exchange Systems training program. This is solely for Laos Republics. And Bank of Laos PDL, Ministry of Finance, Stock Market Stable Committees was invited in Korea Security Depository. And right now, Laos government is planning to establish Laos Stock Exchange. This is the main part of capitalistic oriented, right? Systems like this way, Laos Stock Exchange is like this way. So all of them, most of them, came to Korea to share experience to back to their countries. These are the main feature of capacity development, how we invited public officials all over the world to Korea to share and to do that. Economic development. Economic development is, I think, main engine of poverty reduction. Without economic development, this is based on sand. It's groundless. This is very fragile. Therefore, economic development is, I think, a precondition to achieve social development over there. But economic development is, there are many stages from agricultural, rural development to IT. This is high tech over there. So we would like to have many courses in line with their economic stage. Premier stage, we focused on rural development or something like that. In case of a very advanced developed countries, we focused on IT or whatever, based on their economic status. We focused on their status like this way. Agricultural productivity, the main primary stage of that. For example, Vietnam Semal Undong pilot project was implemented by COICA in as of rural development series. In 2006, for example, 2 villages and 300,000 project was spread to right now, 650 villages over there. And 2010, every rural development project was combined as a Langmoy movement. This is a new village movement is spread to Africa. In Vietnam. As of today, we have very good programs of rural development. Someone says positive way, others say a negative way. There are very controversial arguments regarding Semal Undong like this way. But to my understanding, when I visited the many Asian countries, African countries, I feel that if our program might be adjusted to local conditions, I think there's many room for Korean rural development programs to be there, to have a very good result of that. In case of Asia, it was proved, evaluated, have very good result, no doubt about it. But in Africa, in Latin America, let's see what is the result of this one. If we have good result from that, we have a very good model of it, and then to share our experience with them. And also, we have, you know, to implement this kind of good program, Semal Undong programs, we have right now combined our program with the UN. So in Tanzania and Uganda, we have so-called Korea Village, Millennium Village projects to achieve in Millennium Development Goal in sub-Saharan Africa, $8 million US dollars for that. This picture shows the signing ceremony with the many, head of organization, Mr. Ban Ki-moon. You are familiar with him, of course. And left the former president of COICA, and the right, Mr. Kim Gan-young. This is the governor of Gyeongsangbuk province. They are working very hard to implement the Semal Undong to Africa as of today. And far right, you can see Jeffrey Sachs. He is a well-known professor of development right now in Columbia University. And others, Mr. Do Young-shim, a former parliamentary member, right now is the head of staff, and others. This is a signing ceremony, and it is implementing right now. Maybe next year we can see the result of it. I hope. We have good result. I hope. So that we can provide more and more result-oriented projects to other countries of that. IT projects. This is the highest level of the projects because it is needs skillful labor forces and then infrastructure out of that. And one of case study of, there are so many cases of it, IT projects. But I'd like to share with you one or two examples of COICA's IT programs, especially in Bangladesh, Korea IT Training Center program. This is IT projects Bangladesh. And it's always gone. But there are so many projects is going on, especially in vocational training programs over there. Vocational training program, you know, how to have a skill from very primary to very skilled programs. Horticultures, beautician. This is very simple techniques. But it is very important for African woman to earn the money. With this kind of money, she can bring their children to school, which is sustainable, very important for their families to do that. Even though this is very simple techniques of that. But anyhow, vocational training is very important. One of them is IT. IT is one of vocational training programs, IT, computers, and for example, beauticians, horticulturists. There are so many kinds of vocational training programs. So we'd like to focus on IT or vocational training programs. Aid for trade is also economic development, one part of it. Aid is not a panacea. Panacea, I mean, the drug or the medicine to solve everything. We can see 만병통치약. We can in Korea we saw that. Aid should be seed money. It should not be the role of the panacea. Why aid is not effective, failed in Africa? Because it was, they are addicted to aid. So we don't want Africa peoples to be addicted by aid. Aid should be the role of seed monies. And more important is their trade capacity buildings. Aid should be for support of their trade promotions, like this way. So aid for trade concept is development with this kind of context. Aid should be seed money or support role for aid promotions, trade promotions like this way. So aid for trade is very important concept or issues right now in international community with the institution buildings. And we'd like to deliver export-oriented industrialization and export promotion policies to other countries because we have very good programs about it, even though we are not ultimately good programs at all. We have some pros as well, but we'd like to share not only our positive aspect of it, but negative aspect of it, how to recover from IMF bailout in 1997, for example. We have also trial and errors here. So we'd like to share not only positive, but also negative thing together so that different countries can understand what, you know, Korea involved in this process to overcome the obstacles and the many limitations about it. Aid for trade in Cambodia, for example, we invited many officials from Cambodia to here to have capacity building in trade, goods and services in Cambodia, and also how to their smooth soft landing in WTO systems like this way. So we'd like to share this one. Finally, evaluation workshop is in Cambodia to share our experience. We provided the report, final report to Cambodian peoples, Cambodian public officials, so that this is our main goals like this way. This is aid for trade economic development like this way. Okay, let's turn to social development. Time is so limited, so I'd like to sometimes skip, but you understand what it means. Social development. This is, of course, linked with economic development. Economic development, I told you that this is a basis for social development. So we have a very good program in social development, the family planning projects, like this way. This was so successful to such an extent that we are right now afraid of future labor force shortages, like this way in Korea. 1960s, one woman has generally six children. As of today, this is too low in the world, 1.2 children in 2012. How successful, how successful the family program was all about. But right now, government has changed their policies to have more children, to have more incentive, to have more labor forces in the future, so like this way. And also, Koika, we also have many primary health care projects, maternal health, family health planning project in all over the world. These are one of quite adventurous side of projects of Koika program, family programs and clinic programs. Not big hospital, but very small, but very effective clinics all over the world. Koika health project in Peru. In Peru, we have six hospital projects, all of them, working quite well. And then many children and women's access to our hospital facilities like this way, and it's pretty good impact on, especially in minorities, Mormon children's, and like this way. And social development, vocational training programs. As I told you, this is a very important part of it, to provide a skill, technicians for their living. It is basis for their life as well. We have many, many good projects, especially in programs, job creation, employment, income growth, industrializations as well, and almost is 100 projects was done in less than 20 years in all over the world. In Vietnam, we have Vietnam Industrial Technology Schools over there, which is a very good school in Vietnam. And our volunteers dispatched there to play the role of teachers over there. And it's working quite well. And a very good labor forces, very skilled, qualitative workforces was bring about in this school. Education is also another area of social development. We have very good experience in primary, secondary education experience like this way. And one of the examples is Lao textbook supply projects from 2007 to 2009, amounting $3 million. You look at this picture, Lao is still very poor countries, do not have any good textbook at all. Considering this kind of thing, we think it is good for them to provide a new textbook for old student, primary student, secondary student, tertiary student as well. And these are the picture which primary school students was very happy to receive the first year new textbook. If you look back page of the textbook, you can see the two national flag, one Lao, another Republic of Korea. So with just $3 million, it has really everlasting impact on the education of a Lao Republic of that. And these are one example, Koika's program to provide primary and secondary education program. Okay, let's turn to final things for aid effectiveness. In 2000, from 2000, international community focused on more aid and better aid. More aid, you understand that? More and more ODA programs, which Jeffrey Sachs argued very strongly. In order to implement ODA program, Millennium Development Goal programs, we need money. So, which we can call big push programs, big push by Jeffrey Sachs and other colleagues. On the other end, Mr. Stiglitz and William Easterly, Mr. Jang Ha-jun, for example, they are very criticizing the impact of Jeffrey Sachs' big push series. It is not enough to have money. We need more skilled, manageable ODA programs focused on aid effectiveness. So more aid and better aid means aid effectiveness. These are slogans of 21st century in international community to focus on more and better aid. Right now, rather than more aid, to focus on better aid. So, aid effectiveness is the highlighted as of today to think about how to secure aid effectiveness. So, right now, let's give you some hints of COICA and Korean governments to the way to secure aid effectiveness like this way. Three words, ownership, which I like, focus many times how important it is. Second, managing for result, not into input basis but output basis. Show me the result. ODA is 100% tax by the people. So in case of COICA, we have to show, demonstrate the impact of their tax monies toward them. This is your money. This is the result of it. Therefore, we have to show them managing for result is the concept which introduced in 2000 as well. And partnership. Making better world together is the motto of COICA. Why I told you, reiterated, emphasize partnership, not alone, partnership. Because each donor has their different comparative advantage. By doing integration of each comparative advantage, it is more and more result, managing for result. This is so-called the stage of complementarity, complement together. So, program aid. Program aid is quite overall programs. Generally speaking, there are two types of it, program aid and project aid. Project aid is to build hospital, for example, in one some area, to have vocational training center in area. You can say this is a project aid. Program aid is overall comprehensive type of it. For example, in Cambodia, they have their own vocational training policies. So in line with their Cambodia's counterparts' vocational training policies, COICA is integrating our project aid with their comprehensive policy together. This is, we can say, program aid. Program aid is a combination of a total project aid. How, in a logical way, to secure aid effectiveness, rather than very specific project aid, more focused on program aid. Program aid in, you know, guarantees good result because this is a so-called to see the forest rather than to see trees. You understand that? Rather than to see the each trees, to see the overall forest together. This is program aid. So right now, international community focused on program aid rather than project aid. COICA is one of them. For example, vocational training program like this way. Each country has their vocational training policies, human resources training programs like this way. So COICA is in line with their policies. We focused on training facility expansion program, for example, or building female vulnerable people vocational capacity development center, for example. Institutionalized national technology verification test, one of them. Link industrial cluster with human resources. These are project from, incurred from their comprehensive policies. Link together their policies. But in the past, we do not care about their overall policies. We just care about specific projects. That's it. It does not link to the overall policies logically. But right now, every donor country is focused on program aid rather than project aid. And the second types to secure aid effectiveness is PPP, public-private partnership, or private-public partnership. Right now, there are so many private companies, entrepreneurs, to join ODA programs. For example, Samsung Electronics, POSCO, LG, SK, they want to join ODA programs based on their philanthropical contribution toward developing countries. So right now, COICA introduced PPP 3Ps 3 years ago. is quite good successful result of it. One of example is Asian Airlines. Asian Airlines is one of two main airlines in Korea. They want to join COICA program, and it was done in Angkor Wat, in Cambodia. You know Angkor Wat, right? This is a well-known famous sightseeing place in the world. And Asia Airlines, COICA, and Cambodia, APSALA authorities gather together, combine together, and then we have this kind of projects. Solar street light in Angkor Wat. In the past, in the night, there's no light over in the street. But when Asiana Airlines and COICA gather together, 50% financed by Asiana Airlines and 50% by COICA, and there are so many right now this kind of street light. What is the impact of this very small projects? First, in the night there is this kind of light. There are so many vendors to bring their goods to sell their product in the night. Second is the student who want to read books. They came under the discount light to read their books. And because of this light, the crime rate was decreased. Oh wait. So this is a very small project compared with the general COICA projects. However, this is a symbol of private big entrepreneurs to join COICA's activity together. Samsung Electronics right now working with COICA to Africa to have a bridge programs, to have an education program, illiteracy solving programs in Africa right now is working quite well. And POSCO is right now in green revolution in Mongolia, for example. And hopefully more and more entrepreneurs will join, I hope. Maybe we are afraid that they are driven by their national, their interest. Maybe. But we scrutinize the screening process, whether their motivation was driven by their private company's campaign or not. But if we scrutinize that kind of screening programs, I think there is no problem. Maybe some problem, but generally speaking, no problem at all. I believe that. But we can utilize money, techniques, the networking by private companies. In case of USAID, they are working with Coca-Cola projects in Africa, because in Coca-Cola, they have many networking in remote area too. So by doing, working, or by utilizing this kind of Coca-Cola networking, the project is from, you know, main cities to remote area, like this way. So this is one example of USAID partnership with, you know, big entrepreneurs. Countries like this way. COICA is one of them. And another good example is South-South cooperation. South means developing countries, generally speaking. North means developed countries, generally speaking. South-South means from developing countries to developing countries, because developed country knows well the condition of other developing countries. This is a hypothesis of a South-South cooperation. But generally speaking, right now, rather than South-South cooperation, we can use triangular cooperation, South-South-North cooperation, or South-North-North cooperation, like this way. Because South-South cooperation is very important, but they do not have enough monies, enough skills to do that. So North is involved in this process. COICA triangular cooperation in seed potato production in Algeria. Let's give you a good example. Peru is kingdom of the potato. You may know well or not. potato, when I visited Peru, I was shocked to see that more than 1,000 kinds of potato in the world, all of them was grown in Peru. Peru was experts in potato is related. So our president visited Peru, and he talked with the Ministry of Agriculture in Peru to provide some experts and many kinds of potato seed to Algeria, which is suffering from the shortage of the food. But the role of COICA, Korea government, is intermediary role. So, Ministry of Agriculture is involved, COICA is involved, Highland Agricultural Research Center in Gangwon province is also involved there, which is noted for their seed potato number one in Korean research centers, like this way. So, Peru, Algeria, Korea, South-North Cooperation, one of them. This is example of case for aid effectiveness. So right now, every donor, including COICA, USAID, JICA, and DFID in United Kingdom, every donor is working very hard to secure South-North Cooperation together, Triangle Cooperation, to secure aid effectiveness. So aid effectiveness means a partnership, as I told you. Other emerging donors, COICA. Last year, I visited Brazil and Chile to have a memorandum of understanding MOU with Chile and Brazil. Why? Brazil was noted for their Portuguese-speaking countries. They have very good program in Mozambique. COICA has very good projects in Mozambique. So that Brazil aid agencies, ABC, and COICA gather together and to involve in Mozambique projects together. Chile is noted for their good fishery projects. With this kind of combination, Chilean, COICA, and South America projects countries together, we have secure very good training program, which was implemented in Santiago, in capital of the Chile. It's like this way. There are so many ways right now thinking about how to secure aid effectiveness as of today. These are the main issues surrounding ODA programs in the world. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much.